from it here. So we could work in the workshop. A little bit of background noise from my servers. But so we could try and disassemble this old weather station and see what we can find out. See what we can. Oh, well, this has gotten a bit old. I just fell apart. Get it unscrewed from the support. So I'll just keep these screws. They're actually quite cool. Stainless steel. But I don't think I can reuse the stand. Oh, that's a knock. That's a long screw. Separated. This is the wind direction sensor. Let's see if we can open it up. See if we can see what's what. Break this and terrible loss. Thank you. Oh, that was easy. I would swear, cost this folding part. That's a circuit board with more screws. That's one. Nope, that's two. Three! Three screws. Lost the screw, terrible disaster. Now we're gonna put it back together again. Cup holder. I must say that the electronics that it contains is not that cool. Is it there? That could be the magnet that's trying to harden us. And it feels like a magnet. It's metallic. Oh, let's see if we can. Yep. See. And then, basically, this thing rotates. Oh, see the markings of the constant. And then this sits on top of that, and when it rotates, then it induces currents in those. And then it's detected. It might be a little bit of. Doesn't seem to be any active parts on this specific part. So fair enough. I mean that's been rotating for a million years. It doesn't even feel good. It's plastic. So let's have a look at the temperature detector. I'm not just tucked it under the plastic shield. And this is the part that, well, actually let's have a look at the wind speed detector first, because that's the way it's chained. These are like chained together. Look at embedded screws. I have a small screw down here. Hot in here, I didn't stop the extractor. So now change the liquids and work for us. Outside, because it was my main weather station. Before I switch to the new one, do a link reference call for that one. As you see, this is one reason why I wanted to change to the new one. Lost all its blades. Plus it stopped, and the end result was it stopped communicating with the central unit. And then the third is this is not connected to the internet, there it was. So you couldn't get historical data. I mean, I must say I'm quite impressed how it was able to keep itself so clean inside. Taking into account it's got the same bearing places. So, little screw in the ball, we get rid of this cable. That's going to function. Very well screwed together, I must say.
So, we got a bearing there. Ah. Oh, got a magnet. There, and then that rotates. And then we got a simple bar. It just creates a the magnetic field creates a current. I think that might actually be. Let's check what that's underneath. A mechanical in a glass tube reed switch, so when you put a magnetic field on this, then the contacts separate.
Okay,
for something that's going to be used so well. It was the plastic that gave up before the electronics thing. Separate them. Those magnets are busted in front. So, and then here's the rain sensor. So it fills up, and then it, when it's filled up enough, then it will go down, and then it starts filling this side and that. So then you get kind of a tick-tock motion. And then it's sensed. No way to see it in the camera, of course, but it's embedded in a glass tube, and it's a relay, and when you apply a magnet to it, then it changes mode. It might actually say it was, if we use it in part. Well, anyway, so that's now empty, that's just plastic. Here we have the central unit. Oh, it's combined temperature sensing and central unit. Notice this stopped sending. It didn't matter if I changed the batteries. It's still just won't send anything to the battery pump. And then this was not possible to open. seems to be some house. So we're gonna have to use the violence. So what kind of a tool? Last time. Right, electronics. So anyway, this has a radio center in it. Oh, hey, that's cool. Well, that's last time. And then here's the electronics. So this takes the signals from all the different sensors, combines them into weather data, and then sends it to the radio, which is okay, a lot of potted semiconductor stuff on this side. Basically the same story as huge active chips, and that's part of the radio. Okay, that was not probably because I hit it with a nail, like manufacturer. Probably can't make a warranty complaint. Yeah, that's quite a nice package. So this is the only part where you have active part. And I mean, it was able to kept itself quite clean. Oh, I wonder how many years I've used that. 6, 7, more. Should have had a long life. So now we're the only thing left with the actual display unit. Electronics one. And of course this is anti-static stuff. So this is the last unit, so I thought we could just open this up. No battery. Those are the stands. Let's see if there's any screws around here. Quite a lot of screws. Just screw it open. And there's nothing like I can't reuse really anything here. Hopefully got its own now. Yeah. Now we'll see what it looks like. But anyway, I think we understood how the sensors work. And of course the temperature sensor is most embedded. I saw that. I would assume that it's there. That's the temperature sensor. Well, it's embedded in this. So maybe this is the temperature sensing unit. And then all this other electronics is radio. I would assume. And of course there's like few companies that make these, and absolutely endless number of companies that brand their products, or take the product and then brand it as their own. So there's no guarantee. I don't think there's even a name on it. Radio control. The usual Chinese thing. Radio control. Oh, okay. Oh, well, that was just a hold the back on and slide. Whatever. Why they did it that way, I don't know. Batteries. I wonder if this is the... That's the same deal. Temperature sensor for inside temperature. Okay. Cable for... I'm just wondering if I can get that cable out. Was just the slot fit. Oh, that was just the slot fit. No retain. Okay, this is okay. Now you see that's the radio receiver there. It's a dead cable. That's the antenna part. That's the temperature sensor. Humidity sensor, probably. Beeper. A relay? It's a relay. It's a relay. What do we do with a relay? Quite a lot of oscillator circuits I might actually want to install to generic. All these different oscillators, different frequencies. The sauna should be over here. It's still getting too hot in the workshop. Especially at the servers heroes. Much on that board. Probably like a calculator thing. Maybe be able to tell what this chip is. Yep, that's got markings on it. Of course, the colored one doesn't. Okay, that's for the USB drive chip. You could, I think it was that you could store, or was it to get the temperature values off this unit, you could use USB-R. But the software died, it was an older software. Oh, look at that. So that's, plastic. With the cable. This is the actual display unit. Well, it probably actually different parts of it. Displays numbers. Ah, no, wait, are they? Like a press fit through or something. Or is it that they go around and then touch in certain places? So here's the actual LCD. Quite a strong unit. So this is a unit in itself. Oh, look, some rubber bits. Aha, backlight. Without any cables on it. Can't remember if this had a backlight. Yeah. So here you got the LEDs. Okay, so it gets pressed on there, so that's where the control comes. Can't remember, what's this touchscreen? Oh, long time ago. Yeah, this was touchscreen. So this is the touchscreen sensor. This is the LCD, and it kind of presses on there. There are the control edge, which gets pushed down on this side. No, but it's these. This is the conduit, which fell off. So this kind of touches on that, and then it's sandwiched, and then the display kind of sits on top like that, and that's where it gets its control signals. If you found this interesting, then consider subscribing. Hit the like button if you thought the video was worth it. Merch is available. Or if you'd just like to buy me a cup of coffee, that's also possible. The links are in the description, and all the funds will go to buying stuff for the channel, like financing new weather stations. And then, I thought this was worth it. Have an investigation, but now we know how a standard weather station looks like. So I don't think that even if you take a little bit more modern one, it'll be pretty much the same architecture. But anyway, see you in the next one.